Hi, and welcome to IRE TV. I'm Natalie South from Harcourt Solutions, and in this episode, we're going to discuss the landlord experience, the tenant's experience, and how to achieve a 0 days vacancy. We know more than ever that landlords expect fast and accurate communication, and tenants expect the same level of service. I've got Curtis Peretta from realestate.com.au with me today, so make sure you stay tuned. Welcome back and welcome, Curtis Peretta from realestate.com.au. Thanks so much for being with us today.
Thanks for having me, Nat, in what feels like the Sunrise Studio.
Absolutely. It's a fantastic studio, isn't it?
It's pretty good.
Look, I know realestate.com.au have been doing some research around what the landlord experience and what the landlord's expecting from a property management point of view. Can you tell me a little bit about what you're seeing from your side of things?
Yeah, so some of the research has really highlighted that 50% of landlords and property managers often get together in the first instance. So the first business they pick, the landlord's picker, is who they go with. And then the other 50% are actually researching and narrowing down three or more property management businesses before they actually decide on who they pick.
That's really interesting. And guys, this is what we talked about when we were discussing fast and accurate communication. So we know that when a landlord calls into the office or someone sends you a referral, they're expecting an immediate response. So by providing them with one, a phone call, something we do is send an email blue box, which gives them an immediate communication and some information that they could look at. And I guess a timeline on when they can expect to hear from us. So if we can be the first to communicate with them, be the first to show them that we're the professional. When we do get the opportunity to meet with them, we've already set the expectation in terms of what they can expect from us as a property management team.
It also goes into the other sort of key learning, which was 70% of landlords like to get face-to-face with their property manager.
Absolutely. And look, we'll never look to discuss, Curtis, fees over the phone. We'll always try and get that opportunity to get in front of the client because we know when we are face to face with someone, we can build trust and build a better relationship. So the time we do get to the discussion around fees, services and those sort of things, we've already got that advantage. Curtis, you mentioned that 50% of potential landlords look to choose a property manager after interviewing three different property managers. So when they do meet with their property manager, what sort of information are they looking for?
Yeah, Nat, that's a very good question. And a lot of the time, fee is relevant. Mm-hmm. Obviously, people want to know what they're paying for and how much. Mm-hmm. But some of the other things that were key were around the old favourites, I say, the communication. Mm-hmm. How often are you going to communicate with me? What services do you provide over and beyond what's expected of me? What does your marketing look like? Because as an investor, I love my investment property and I want to make sure that it's marketed really well. So they want to know what's your process and strategy to market property, the selection of a tenant. They also want to find out when you find a tenant, what's the process, you know, to get them on board. And you'd have some really great processes and strategies to share about that.
Yeah, perfect. So what I'm hearing a lot, Curtis, is I'm hearing a lot around communication and I'm also hearing a lot around processes and procedures. So basically what you're saying is landlords want communication. They want to know that there's a process and procedure behind the full leasing process and the marketing side of things. And they want to know that there's a really detailed process, again, behind the securing and vetting of a tenant. Is that correct?
100%. And the only extra thing I'd say is highlight your strategy. So this is not your first rodeo. Like finding a tenant is not something that you wake up and think, oh, let's give this a crack today. It's something that is a system or a process or a strategy you have in place in your business. It's just about communicating that to the landlord.
Perfect. Thanks so much for sharing.
We'll be right back.
Now we're going to cover the tenant experience. We know that one in three Australians are tenants, and gone are the days where tenants and landlords get treated differently. Tenants and landlords expect the same level of service. So Curtis, tell us a little bit more about what we can be doing as an industry to provide tenants with a better service and a better process behind their experience with real estates and securing a property.
Yeah, very good question, Nat. And ultimately, I think we need to start with what and how are we attracting the most amount of tenants? Because as we act for the landlord, ultimately they want the best tenant for their property. And so we need to ask ourselves, how are we attracting them in the first place to say with confidence that out of all the people that have applied, we have selected you the best tenant? And I think it starts with the basics, the marketing experience, to let the tenant know that, okay, this agency or this home is a prestigious home or well-marketed home, so I need to bring my A game as well.
Absolutely, and that's another interesting comment, because we find when tenants come through open homes, there's certain information they want to know prior to getting to the property. Things like, is there air conditioning? Is there fans? What's the layout of the home? And what are the sizes of the bedrooms? So I guess for you guys watching, ask yourself, do you have a brand standard from a marketing side of things? And what information are you giving to the tenants to ensure that you attract the most amount of tenants, which will ensure that you get the best price? And you're also able to provide the landlord with multiple applications in terms of who they want to be living in their home.
Yeah. Some of our research recently did actually highlight that landlords, majority of them anyway, have an expectation that they've got a selection of tenants to choose from. Obviously, some of our landlords will trust you and have a relationship with you and just say, Nat, that's why I pay you, you pick someone. But majority of the time, if you can say, look, here are the best three groups of tenants that have come through and applied, mm-hmm. You decide, you know, this is maybe my recommendation, but here's all the information that you need as a landlord or an investor. That then sort of gives you the confidence for the next 12 months throughout the lease to guarantee at least that you've done everything that you can to select them the best tenant.
Absolutely. So to make sure that we get them, you know, get the most tenants through the door, we need to make sure that we're being convenient for tenants. Would that be correct, Curtis?
Flexibility is key. You know, there are where we are today, Inspect Real Estate, have a really great platform to make it easy for tenants to engage and inspect and book when it's convenient for them. Mm-hmm. But the reverse is, customers, property managers need to also be flexible. Tenants are no longer just looking at properties at 5 or 5:30 in the afternoon. Mm-hmm. They might want to view a property in the middle of the day, maybe on a Saturday. Mm-hmm. And so all of these things are important, because it's important for the landlord. The landlord wants to know that you and your process and strategy is doing everything that you can to find me the best tenant, and flexibility is super key.
Absolutely. And when we talk about inspection, guys, think about the property, the area in which the property is, and the demographic you're going to be attracting to the property. Then form an idea or a guideline on when you'll be doing your open for inspection. So, you know, a unit in the city, you'd potentially look at doing a 12 to 12:30 so you get people through on their lunch breaks. 15 minutes won't really work for a city inspection, because people have to leave the office, get there, inspect the property, and then get back. So I think the key is thinking about what tenant's going to be looking at this property, and then catering your marketing strategy or your approach around that to make sure that we get as many people through and that we are allowing tenants to inspect at a time that's convenient to them rather than a time that we dictate, which is why Inspect Real Estate's booking system is so fantastic.
Absolutely. And I think ultimately, if we just peel the onion back a little bit more, it's about understanding your target market. Mm-hmm. So in real estate, we are marketers, and it's about understanding who we're trying to attract and what do we need to do to make it easy for them.
Absolutely. The last topic for today's discussion is around a 0 days vacancy period and the process behind achieving this.
It's very interesting, Nat, because when you said that and when I saw this, I thought, wow, that is a very audacious statement. So I'm actually going to ask you, Nat, if that's all right, what does that look like for you? What does 0 days vacant look like in your business or in your mind to really change that understanding in our industry?
Absolutely. Look, I think it all comes back to educating the landlord. So we know when we launch a property to the market that if it doesn't rent within the first 7 days, that we need to make an amendment in price. When we launch to the market, we know we've got great marketing, we've got photos, a floor plan, we've got all the information there to get the tenants through, and we've got a couple of different opened homes that are going to be suitable to that property and those tenants. We know that we've got the promotion on realestate.com.au and across the other web platforms where they need to be. So it only leaves price.
So you're using evidence and data, conversations from tenants, and just, I suppose, KPIs, right? Like mm-hmm. You should expect X amount of things to happen by that first open home. And if they don't, then there's a problem. And how do you sort of speak to landlords about that elephant in the room, which is price sometimes?
Absolutely. Look, I think it's about setting the expectation from the get-go. So my question to you guys watching today is, do you have a plan B in terms of price that your owner's going to know after the first open home? If we haven't got an application on the property by first thing on Monday morning, now I'm not talking Monday afternoon, I'm not talking Tuesday, because you've obviously got your scripts and dialogues at your open homes that you're using to ensure that you're creating urgency with your tenants and setting that deadline. Is there a plan B in terms of the price the owner's expecting you to call on Monday to get approval for? So essentially a pre-approval for that second price point to ensure that we're then launching again to the market for that next week at a price where the market's going to see value, which decreases the vacancy period.
So when you're having new business conversations mm-hmm. about expectations and service and marketing in your process, mm-hmm. that's the time you're sort of pre-framing with landlords as well about plan A and plan B?
Absolutely. Guys, we don't dictate price. The market dictates price. So if we launch to the market and we've got good marketing, we've got good promotion, and we don't achieve an outcome because we know there's plenty of tenants in the market at the moment, it can only be price. So look, I say to my landlords, we don't dictate the price. The market dictates price. So you launch to the market where you feel comfortable with. But all I ask is that we have an agreement that if after the first 7 days we haven't achieved that outcome, then we will be making an amendment to the price from there. And landlords are absolutely okay with that.
How do you deal with the situation, Nat, where let's give it another week comes in? You know, I'm optimistic, Nat. You know, let's give it another week. We'll find those tenants eventually. What would your response be to that?
Absolutely. Look, this is where we use the evidence you mentioned. So we use Inspect Real Estate for their inspection reports. And guys, not sure if you know this, but you can actually tailor your Inspect Real Estate reports to make sure that you're giving the information to the landlord that allows them to make a really informed decision. So we talk about who's been through the property, how long they're looking at staying in the property, when they're looking at moving in, what they liked about the property, and if they had any concerns about the property. So by the time we get to this stage, we've actually already educated the landlords in terms of who's coming through and what they're looking for and why their property might not be suitable. We then back that inspection report up with a marketing overview in terms of how many people are looking at their property, how many people are saving the ad versus how many people are inquiring. So when they're having that conversation to say, Nat, we want to wait another week, back it up with evidence. Talk about, you know, $500 a week, Curtis, your property is actually losing overall $9 on average by the time you secure a tenant if it was to sit vacant for an extra week. We actually know that there's an average days of 15 days from when people apply for a property to when they're physically going to be moving into the property. So, Mr. Landlord, are you happy to have another vacancy period of 3 to 4 weeks? Because that's potentially what you could be looking at if you don't make an amendment now.
From what you're saying, I'm hearing you're relying on the process. This is a process, not your first rodeo, and you're really demonstrating that to landlords to give them confidence, but also be a little bit assertive to say, hey, look, this is the plan, we're off track, and this is what we need to do to get back on track.
Absolutely. Look, there's never a question in terms of what the next step is. There's only a question in terms of what the next step of the process is.
Awesome.
Perfect. Look, thanks so much for coming, Curtis. Thanks for being here today with us. Thank you for watching. I'm Natalie South from Harcourt Solutions. If you wanted to have a bit more of a discussion around how we as an industry can uplift the service we're providing to landlords and tenants, feel free to reach out to me. This is IRE TV. Thank you for watching.